right here, Tyrone Muggsy Bogues, arguably the greatest point guard in Baltimore basketball history, part of the legendary Dunbar teams, won 59 straight games, national championship, three members of that team, including this young man right here, drafted in the first round of the 1987 NBA draft. And tonight, he will be the guest speaker here at the McCormick Unsung Heroes Award Banquet, and we are proud to have him with us here. Pre-dinner interview, and Muggsy, I gotta ask you, it's been over 30 years since you, David Wingate, Reggie Lewis, Reggie Williams, Timmy Dawson, I mean, the names, you know, Coach Wade, Herman Reed, wore the uniform, the crimson and gold of Dunbar, and today it still is relevant. Are you shocked by this, that people still talk about you guys 30 years later?
Well, I guess the older generation kind of keep that story going. The younger generation probably now know about the Boys of Dunbar because of the exposure that we were able to get on the ESPN. Trying to have such a great coach who was a mentor, who was a father figure, that really embodied the message of being a student athlete. You know, our goal was just trying to better our life. You know, we was had not the NBA on our mind. We just wanted to get an education and possibly go to school to, you know, to better our life. And having Mr. Wade, who already been there and done that, having that philosophy, you know, kind of, you know, we wanted more. We wanted that. We wanted what he had and what he was preaching to us. So, you know, we was fortunate enough, you know, to have that success, and where collectively, you know, we would stay humble, we stay grounded, and at the same time, we was able to do some amazing things.
Talk about your career. I mean, here you are, 5'3". Everyone doubted you. The line of doubters could probably reach from here all the way down York Road to Towson. I mean, just talk about just coming up and just beating the odds. I mean, going to Wake Forest, being an all-ACC basketball player, being drafted in the first round, playing 10 years in the NBA. 14. Still 14 years. 10 years with Charlotte, right? I mean, and still, people still don't believe what you did.
So, and I had a goal. I had a vision. You know, and I saw that. And each way, I kind of, you know, put myself in the best situation. And that was, you know, it said about it in elementary school and junior high school and high school. You know, you're going to be facing bigger, stronger players. We were, we had to go out there and show them that anyone's capable of playing this game. And the main, in my mindset, was if I played against the best, I have success against the best, you must be included with the best. So I took that mindset on the floor each and every time, and it worked out well for me. And it put me in a position where, you know, now I'm part of history.
Talk about the game, the NBA game, when you was a player. Now that you're outside of it, kind of looking on TNT, ESPN, I mean, talk about the game now from what it was then.
It's a different product out there today. We was a lot more physical. I was forward. We had a center. You know, today's game, you have more of a stretch four, as opposed to a center that's 7 feet now facing the basket as opposed to playing with his back towards the basket. But, you know, that's all each era. You know, it changes and it become a trend. The NBA is doing a great job marketing the product. You know, the guys are having a lot of success sharing the basketball. You know, you see a lot more movement and it's become more exciting for the fans. So, you know, the three ball has been more emphasis, has been more of an emphasis of today's game. You know, you got young Steph Curry now shooting the ball from half court. So, you know, and people and the kids really relevant for that. But, you know, it was a great place, great time for me. You know, the era that I played in, you know, with the Magic Johnson, the Irvin, the Michael Jordans, you know, the Larry, the Birds and so forth, Isaiah Thomas. So, you know, for me,
coached, and you deal with a lot of youth, somewhere in Charlotte. What's the message that you give to kids? And what's the message you're going to give to these young men and women tonight here at the McCormick Unsung Hero Awards Banquet?
Well, it all starts with the confidence within yourself. You know, without that confidence, it's very likely that you'll be successful because you can easily be influenced. People will discourage you, discount you from who you are. And when you give them that ammunition, it takes away for the true gift that God has given you. Because you also must recognize that God gave everybody a gift. And I was fortunate enough to be blessed to recognize what that gift was at an early age. And I always try to tell the young folks that, you know, you gotta understand who you are. Having that understanding at an early age, it allowed me to go on and do some amazing things. Because if I wouldn't have had that confidence, if I would have believed in what other folks were saying about me, I wouldn't be here talking to you today. So I'm grateful and thankful that I recognize that gift that God has gave me at an early stage, and I try to share that with the youth.
McCormick, and of course, these young men and women here at Valley Mansion in Cogginsville are going to be very fortunate to hear your words tonight, Muggsy Bogues. Baltimore basketball, this is the gold standard of Baltimore basketball. Tyrone Muggsy Bogues, part of those iconic Dunbar teams from the 1980s. He is again here as guest speaker here at the 78th Annual McCormick Unsung Heroes Award Banquet.